click on the subscribe button and remember to press the bell icon for regular notifications from our digital blogger. Hello friends, welcome to our digital blogger. Today we're going to compare HDFC Securities with Tradebulls, two full service stock brokers. We'll talk about multiple aspects including company background, account opening charges, brokerage rates, exposure or leverage, quality of research, level of customer service and performance of trading platforms. We also talk about some other features that can help you to figure out HDFC Securities or Tradebulls, which of these two is a better one for you. Let's get started. So starting the company background, Tradebulls has been recently established in the year 2009 as compared to HDFC Securities that was launched back in the year 2000. HDFC Securities is the trading arm of HDFC Bank, so certainly it enjoys a lot of brand equity created by the bank company over the years. As far as physical presence is concerned, Tradebulls has around 18 sub-brokers and franchise locations across different parts of India. HDFC Securities enjoys around 250 locations with its franchise locations. As far as memberships is concerned, BSE and NSE is the membership HDFC Securities has attained, while Tradebulls has additional memberships of MCX, SX, MCX and NCDEX. So definitely HDFC Securities looks much more trustable, but if we talk about the account opening charges, this is where differences get a bit stark. Now you need to pay around 1000 rupees to open the trading account with HDFC Securities. This is free with Tradebulls, but then there is an AMC of around 350 rupees that is supposed to be paid every year. HDFC Securities charges you 750 rupees, pretty hefty again. So certainly at the upfront you're going to pay a lot to HDFC Securities, and annually that is a recurring cost every year in form of AMC. Even in that particular aspect, HDFC Securities is a bit expensive. Then comes to brokerage. Now this is something you're supposed to pay in every trade. Now these are full service brokers. They're going to charge you a specific percentage values of your overall trade. Now for instance, if you trade with Tradebulls with 1 lakh rupees, you're going to pay around 200 rupees for one trade in equity delivery, and with HDFC Securities is going to be around 500 rupees for that particular trade. Similarly, in other segments you can see more or less HDFC Securities is a bit expensive as compared to Tradebulls. So certainly when it comes to bank-based stock brokers, not only HDFC Securities but ICICI Direct or Axis Direct or Kotak Securities, all of them fall in the premium range. They give you the trust factor, but certainly they give it at a very high price. Now you can calculate the specific brokerage charges or the overall taxes you're going to pay in your trades to these brokers. This can be done through brokerage calculators we have developed at our digital blogger. You can have a small demo here. So this is ourdigitalblogger.com. You can visit this website and check the brokerage calculation, not just brokerage but also taxes for around 80, more than 80 brokers rather. And for that you just need to select a particular broker here. Here in this case we are going to do for HDFC Securities and Tradebulls. So let's say you go ahead with equity delivery trade and your buy price is, let's say, for this example being 1500, sell price is 2000, number of shares, let's say you bought 100 of them. I'm just doing it for this demo. You can, these numbers obviously can be as per your requirement. So once you've filled in these values, the state is required for calculating stamp duty. You need to click on calculate. Once you do that, the overall numbers will be displayed to you. 1750 is your brokerage out of the 350,000 trade value. Then STT is 350 rupees, stamp duty 35, transaction charge is 11.38. GST is also applicable at 317.05 rather. So overall brokerage and taxes are somewhere around 2463.95. In this particular trade, you're gonna make 47536.05 rupees. So this is when you do it with HDFC Securities. You can do this with the Tradebulls as well, putting in the same numbers here. Let's say 1500 to 1100, and we put it Gujarat. So once you do that, click on calculate, you will get similar thing, but the brokerage is much lesser at 70 rupees as compared to 1750. You can see. So I guess there is something wrong here because I went ahead with the intraday, so it's going to be 700 rather. Sorry for the mistake, it's not delivery. So 700 as compared to 1750. Your overall takeaway in this case of Tradebulls is 48775 as compared to 47536. So around 1200 extra profit you make if you go ahead with Tradebulls, simply because of the cheapness of the brokerage rates with this calculator. Now this is this becomes very simple once you actually go ahead and do the calculation, because if you don't do this, you will not really have an understanding of how much you will be paying out in your trades, and with this in mind, you are going to lose out a lot in your profit as well. So this is about brokerage. Next up, we have exposure or leverage. Now, for people who do not understand this concept, basically this kind of a short-term loan that is offered by your broker at a specific rate of interest. Now, this interest rate can be in the range of 15 to 22, 23%. In this example here, Tradebulls gives you 10 times for intraday and 3 to 5 times for delivery. HDFC Securities goes up to 20 times. In other segments, there's nothing that HDFC has to offer. So let's say if you have trading account balance of 10,000 rupees, with Tradebulls you can trade up to 1 lakh in intraday, and with HDFC Securities it can go up to 2 lakh rupees. So it really depends on the kind of segment you're putting your money. At the same time, you have to be very sure of the risks and implications of using this concept in the first place. If you do not understand how it works, it's better to avoid it, otherwise it can actually kill your profits too. Then we have customer service. Now Tradebulls and HDFC Securities gives you similar number of communication channels. HDFC Securities gives you live chat, but they do not give you toll free number, which is given by Tradebulls. But when it comes to the quality of customer support, HDFC Securities is a far better stockbroker as compared to Tradebulls in terms of the skill set, in terms of the professionalism, in terms of the turnaround time of the executives. Tradebulls has a lot to improve. HDFC Securities has been doing a decent job, but certainly is better than Tradebulls. Then it comes to research, reports and recommendations. Here as well, HDFC Securities wins it marginally. The difference is not that huge in this case though, but still, if you want to trust the recommendations and tips and reports from the broker, in this particular case here, better to go with HDFC Securities. There's one concern though: in trading products, you cannot put your money in commodity segments because HDFC Securities will not allow you to trade or invest in commodities. This is not a problem when it comes to Tradebulls. They would allow you to go ahead and trade in commodities segment. Then we have some other features. It really depends whether you need them in the first place or not. For instance, automated trading is something provided by Tradebulls. HDFC Securities does not do that. 3-in-1 accounts are basically given by bank-based stockbrokers only. So it's something basically, the way it works is that your trading account is connected with your bank account, and the fund transfer process happens automatically. You do not need to do anything manual in this case. So that is the USP of a 3-in-1 account, and that is given by HDFC Securities as well. Now, it really depends whether you need that, simply because these days a lot of payment gateways or mobile wallets have come into picture, making the whole fund transfer thing a very easy and convenient process. Now we'll talk about the trading platforms. Very, very crucial, very important aspect, because if your trading platform is not going to perform at the right time, at the right price, you are not going to make profits. So we will talk about all of that one by one. We will start with the mobile application of these brokers here, and for that we need to check out Google Play Store. So start the mobile app of HDFC Securities, rated at 4.1 by around 21,000 users, out of which around 11.8% of them have rated this app negatively. Overall satisfaction score is around 88.2%, which is pretty good. If you look at the numbers here, the last update was done on 17th of November 2017. Generally, they update the mobile app in the range of 4 to 5 weeks, which can be improved marginally. Number of installs 5 lakh to 1 million. From numbers perspective, the application looks recommendable. There are a few concerns. For instance, there have been a lot of login related issues that have been seen. At the same time, if you want to access your portfolio section, there will be access issues there, and the app has been found relatively slow in performance when it comes to smaller cities. Otherwise, you can go ahead with the application of HDFC Securities. There's not much of a problem in your regular trades and you will not be having any bad user experience. Then the mobile app of Tradebulls called Tradebulls Touch is rated at 3.8 by around 200 users. The sample size is very small, out of which around 25% have rated this app negatively. Overall satisfaction score is around 75%. Industry average is somewhere around 81%. If you look at the update frequency, the last one was done in 28th of November 2017. Generally, the updated mobile app in the range of 5 to 6 weeks is similar to what HDFC Securities does. Number of installs 10,000 to 50,000. There are a few concerns as well. You have to be very sure whether you should be going ahead with this application or not. For instance, it consumes a lot of internet bandwidth. So you have to be sure the kind of internet connection you have. It should either be an unlimited internet connection or it should be a Wi-Fi with a specific plan. Otherwise, you will actually lose out on your trades. Then there are performance related issues. The speed is a concern regularly put out by the clients of Tradebulls. UI is also pretty fancy. There's no specific clarity on the widgets on what it wants the client to perform. So there are some usability concerns, especially if you're a beginner. You might have a hard time understanding different features and navigations of this application. So if you want to pick one of these two, certainly you should be going ahead with HDFC Securities. Mobile application is much more mature, much more prominent. It has seen a lot of feedback and incorporations over its existence. Now we'll talk about the other trading platforms, and for that we need to check out digitalblogger.com. So starting with HDFC Securities, they give you HDFC Sec. Now this is basically a web-based browser application. You need to just go to the website of HDFC Securities, click on login, and you can start trading. Number of features are pretty exhaustive. You can customize them. At the same time, you can use different types of charts for technical analysis. Since it's a full service broker, they also provide you tips and recommendations, research reports within this application. Then there is Blink. Now this application is very exhaustive in terms of performance, speed, number of features, technical analysis. It gives you real-time market movement, transaction monitoring with different types of order books. Then you have a single UI for equity and future option trading. Similarly, if you look about the speed, if you're an expert level trader, you will not really have much of a complaint using this application. The only problem is that this is a paid software. You cannot use it for free. For 6 months, you're supposed to pay around 3,000. For 1 year subscription, you need to pay around 4,000 rupees to HDFC Securities. Then mobile application we've already discussed is available across different platforms: Android, iOS, iPad, and BlackBerry. Number of features are good, certainly can be used for your trading purposes. So we have seen that there are multiple trading platforms offered here across devices, and all of them pose a decent sort of a proposition value to their clients. Then if we talk about Tradebulls, now this is a Tradebulls client, a web-based browser application. Number of features are pretty limited, but at the same time gives you a reasonable trading experience. So if you are a beginner to, let's say, an intermediate level trader, you can go ahead with Tradebulls client. Tradebulls Diet is a terminal-based solution. Number of features are pretty exhaustive. It's a customized version of Audience Diet, so you can certainly use it for trading. User experience is going to be a concern because this is something not maintained by Tradebulls themselves. They've outsourced this particular trading application. Then there is Tradebulls Touch, the mobile app. We've already discussed this. A lot of things that needs to be improved in this, and certainly if you're comparing it with HDFC Securities mobile app, you should go ahead with the latter. So in case of Tradebulls, yes, they also have presence across all the devices, like in case of HDFC Securities. But in case in terms of performance, in terms of the maturity of the trading platforms, in terms of the number of features introduced, the overall impact that is going to create in your trades, in your trading experience, HDFC Securities look way better. But still, if you want to try with a low brokerage to full service broker, in that particular case, it's not a bad option. So that is it as far as comparison between these two full service stock brokers is concerned. We have talked about for multiple aspects here. We started with the company background, we talked about pricing, brokerage, research, then we talked about trading products, platforms, a lot of things. Now you have to see what you want, and based on that you can make a choice for yourself. However, if you want us to help in figuring out the stockbroker that matches exactly with your requirements, you can check out this link here, digitalblogger.com/free, call back broker choice, put in your details and your preferences. we will arrange a call back for you absolutely free. So that's it for the video. Thank you so much for watching it. We hope you liked it. In case you did, please go ahead and press the thumbs up link. We'll really appreciate that. You can also subscribe to us on different social media channels, Facebook, Twitter, Tumblr, SlideShare, and YouTube, where we update content on a regular basis. Thank you so much for watching this video again. Bye-bye.